that mum truck. Just trying to get the chat to pop out. Let's see if I've come on here yet. Here we go. Hi Vicky. Hi Pickle. Welcome. Sorry you got chucked off, Pickle. You having trouble with alt rain, are you? Is sound okay, guys? Yep, we've got sound. I'll just talk through what I've done so far in this picture while we wait to see if any others come in. What I've done so far is the mushrooms. I've done the shading and the colouring on it. Finished all the airs, done the stalks on the mushrooms, just need to come in with the greenery now. Yep, you'll not be nervous next time. And hopefully the weather will be better. Thank you. Yeah, I've got to decide what I want to do for a background. I'm thinking I might do a stormy sky because that could explain why they're all running. But I'm not 100% on that yet. I'm still deciding. I've got shading to do on logs still. And I've got butterfly wings to do, but I've got some iridescent to put on them. I didn't think you'd want to see me do all little tiny details over and over on streams, so I've been doing that in background, but when I do the sky, I'll do a stream. So that's where I've got to with that. Put my bit of paper back in. And what I thought we'd do today is this fox. It's from Artistry by Lisa Marie on Etsy. I've put a link down below. Hi Caroline, welcome. And I thought we'd do this with pastels today. And also to mention that I keep getting asked to put my wishlist link down below. I've done that, but please bear in mind I don't want anybody to feel obliged to buy me anything. There's also some expensive stuff on there, but I don't want you to pay for anything like that. That's just there for my family so they know what I want for the channel. I don't think I've got anything else that I need to tell you all. I keep meaning to write notes so I know what to say. Oh yeah, I keep missing conversation when people come to the stream, and it's not intentional, I'm just flaky. When I get colouring, I forget to keep looking at chat, but I am getting better at it. But if I do miss you, please repeat what you're wanting to say if it's for me. You might have to repeat it two or three times. Hi Kimmy, welcome. But please don't think that I'm ignoring you, because that's not the case. Were there anything else I'd got to say? No. apart from I'm very forgetful and I wish I'd wrote notes down. Yeah, that's true, Jodie. I've been praying it off, and I keep getting people asking me. And I'm not very good at receiving gifts. I don't know what to say to people. So I've been saying no, I won't share a wish list, but the two people have been very persistent. So I've put it on, but like I say, nobody's obliged to buy anything. It just stops people from asking me to put it up. So how is everybody today? Hope everybody's well. Yeah, true. I'm glad you're great, Kimmy. That's good to hear. I thought you were breathing before. I kept giving you hints. Your picture looks beautiful, by the way, Jodie. Thank you, Caroline. I have put a link to this. It's on Etsy. I've put a link down below. It's from Artistry by Lisa Marie. Hi, Connie, welcome. So I thought we'd do this with chalks today and see how we go. I've got a collection of tools, different variety of tools that I use. I've got different size brushes, I've got makeup doodads. Can't remember what they're called. But I'll start with a brush and I'm going to build the colour up light. You'll probably not see it to start off with, but I'm just mapping out where I want the colour. So I'll start. I've got the inscribed pastels again, that's similar to ink. The Mungo. Not using the slate today or water. I'm going to ask Ian to spray this for me after with fixative. So I'm going to go in with this light ready orange to start off with. Could get quite a bit on the brush. Pull sleeves up. And the fox is mainly a red and brown all over this area because he's looking away from the light. And like I say, you're not going to see much colour, if anything at all, to start off with. I'm just mapping out where the colour goes. So I want the ready orange on them areas. Now we're lighter on the above the eyes, so I'm going to come in with a yellow tone so that it don't muddy it up when we come down with the red and brown. So if I put that in first, that will stay as an highlight. Same way under here, I want this white, so I'm going to come in with white and put quite a bit of white on there. Just so it don't mucky it again. Right. Now if I come in darker, deeper, should I say, not darker, deeper, and just make sure there's plenty of white around that muzzle, then we'll not get any dark colours in it because I'm pushing this quite deep into the paper. That's the one area where you don't want any colour coming in. So it's good to plot it out first. Same on this section on his ears. You will get some colour in there, but we want it to stay light. So I'm mapping that out as well. And the top of his nose, I want a slight yellow tone just there where the light comes off. Right, let's start then, eh? And just chat, make sure I've not missed anything. Did you say aircon's missing, Connie? Or have you hit wrong letters? Well, you took all streams down for, Jodie. Even tests need to be seen. And then people will subscribe to you and come back next time. Right, we'll go in with some colour now then. So I want a reddy brown. I'll try this one. Yeah, that one's okay. And I just want to lay some down just in random spots. And then we can move it round. And I want a touch of red orange. And that's too similar to the other one. Try this one. That's better. Some darker sections. Back at ear, be darker. And down here. Behind ear. I'm only dotting because it moves around with either brush or a makeup pad, whatever you're using. A bit in snout. And then we want some highlight colour, so I'm going with the yellow. I want it just down here and across the brow. Bit in that ear there and a bit there. Right, try that and see how we got. I'm going to start around this ear and I'm not pressing, I'm just gently moving the colour around where we need it. And I always start off light and build colour up as I need it, because you can't take it away unless you sit there rubbing it. But this card that I'm using is only thin, so I don't want to keep hitting it with a rubber. want some darker tones now, so I'm coming in with whatever colour that is. Gone brain dead. And I'm just bringing it in front of the ear and behind the ear. I don't want to move this round, so I'm just patting that one in. I think I best zoom in a little bit. I usually work 3 or 4 layers, Jodie. Let me just find my camera settings and I'll zoom you in a little bit. How's that? Center it again. Bit more. There we go. Oh, enjoy your lunch, Caroline. Hope I haven't missed anybody coming in. Right, I want some grey now to just to put around his snout here, where it goes to meet the white. It'll have a grey tone. Again, I'm patting it in because I don't want to move that round either. A bit darker. Better. The transition between the white and the colour, you always see a grey tone. Put some around this eye while I've got the grey out. Right. Hey Tracy, welcome. That's alright, Kimmy, you lurk away. Right, coming in with this colour now, and I'm going to deepen up just at the base of this snout. It's not something you can rush when you're doing animals. If you put plain colour down like that, it's just going to look flat. So you have to go in small tiny strokes, keep changing colour and build it up. Big dark tone up there. An animal fur hasn't got just one tone. It's got five or six different tones. One strand of hair can have three colours alone. So if you take your time and you build your tones up as you're going, you have a more realistic looking animal. Some in front of the ear. It's going to be quite dark there. And just red tone again. That one this time. Mid tone. You see the colour is starting to build up in the areas that I want it. Hey Gary, welcome. Alright, just yellow tone again. Back to brown tone. Just fit crease at neck as it's starting to fold round and come to the white. It has a dark spot. So I've got the dark brown red that runs on a line round that way. And then it's lighter again as it's hitting the light towards the back. I want us grey again to come into the front of here. Because even though we've got white, we still need grey in it. Which one did I have for my grey? Done with taping this to table, it's moving. How's that looking, guys? That's just the base coat. I ain't done his ears yet. Red in this area. Thank you, Tracy. Oh, thank you, Jodie. I'm glad you're enjoying it, because I enjoy doing animals. Right, I'm going to take some dark into the centre of this ear. And I want a red tone with it. And it mixes quite well on the page when you're doing it dry. You can't, when you're using it wet, of course, like I usually do it, you have to use the slate then. Used. Leave that over there, preserve it for white. Right. Now, got some yellow tone in front of this ear again. Not that one, just that one. I'm not bothering about the actual strands yet, because pencils will define that. Some grey under here. Thank you, Jodie. This is like a creamy white. So rather than leave the card white background, I'm using this. We've got. That's the front. Right, we want to bring some red in again with this edge. Some yellow tones in it. Thank you, Caroline. I'm sorry to hear that, Gary. Hope he recovers soon. Right. Now, that wants a bit of dark into it, so I'll take that one. And we're just random strands. I'm not pressing very hard because it leaves marks, because it goes deeper into the card and you can't move it. All I'm doing is laying colour light touch, as light as I can get it. And then just gently pat it into the card. Screen. I think that needs some dark coming in, so take it on this back edge. That's better. Thank you, Gary. Hi, Amanda, welcome. And I tell everybody, keep looking through a screen, either a phone screen or a computer screen, camera, because you get a better perspective of what it looks like. Your eyes fool you. All you see is a flat image and you think, oh, that colour don't transition to that colour very well, and your light. And I bet I've forgot my coffee. Yeah, cold coffee again, Chuck. Right, so where do we need to go now? Right, well, that up near that ear is too yellow, so I'm going to come in with some mid-red and just tone the yellow down a little bit, but not much. We still want the highlight there. I'm just gently patting it in. I don't want to rub all over the card and lose where I've put my highlights. Welcome back, Connie. What you lost? Right, that's enough red now. I don't need to add any more to that. I've still got his ear to finish on the inside. I'm going to do that now before I move the page up to do underneath the fox. So I want that colour coming into his ear because it's going to be quite dark in the centre. Try that. I want a bit of red at the base. Right. Dark edge. And then I can bring the red up into it. Serve the white again. And that edge. Right, now I'm going to move the picture up so we can get to the base. Just wait for it to come on my screen so I can see if I'm in the right place. There we go. Right, as we start seeing here, he's hunched up now, so he's got his leg that's going to cause shadow, and he's also got his tail that's going to cause shadow on his leg. So I'm going to put the dark shadow in first. Then we can build the red on top. And again round here. And again, I'm only patting it in, I'm not rubbing it all over the card. Just want to preserve that shadow line. Right, and then after the shadow, it's going to be the red tones, but not as light as this red yellow tone, because we're still casting half a shadow between the leg and the tail. So I'm going to come in with a new brown, and I'm going to take it off of that. Not going into that because that is white, so that'll want dark grey just on the base of there. But he's got a leg that's just hiding here. So I want that on there. And then I'm taking a yellow tone to highlight the front of his leg. Mix that in. The lighter one for that. Put some red in that. We got. Bye, Amanda. Have a great day. Right. Then, miss the white and come over here. Bring red. And I'm going right over what I've already done as well, because I want red tones in the shading as well. Pat that in. Thank you, Jodie. Right, I'm going back to my light tones now. I'm joining it back up to where we're coming. I'm still only doing a section at a time. That way I don't add too much colour to start off with. Tone down here, darken it up a bit. got. Right, now to bring red into the leg. Again, I'm coming off the dark and bringing it up. Yellow highlights, put a bit of that one in. Right, let me see, do we need more shading in that? I think we do. Some more on this bit. Yeah, just the cheapo eyebrow eyeshadow spongy type things. I also have these makeup brushes if I want to do light touches, or mix the colour in a little bit more in areas. Then I use the brush, but mainly I use the sponges. Oh, is Caroline going? Bye, Caroline. Have a good day. See you soon. Right, I'm coming now with the red and yellow again. We're coming up to meet the other colour. I always pat it in first to grade where I want the colour, and then when I'm happy then I can rub it in. it's not red up here. Do we need any more? Some more of that brown. What's on that line there? This red tone. Right, now for the tail, I want a white preserving at the top. Put that in first. They are a lot faster. And thank you, Jodie. I like using pastels. Everybody finds something that they like doing. Mine's pastels. Right, want some colour just in there, but we've got green leaf coming up. So I have to be careful not to touch them. I can rub it out, of course, if I do, but it's easier for me if I just try and avoid it to start off with. It is, Jodie. We'd be boring if we all did the same thing, wouldn't we? Right, take some more of that colour. There's greenery coming up in the middle of there. That's a thick leaf, so I'll not touch that yet till I know where it is. I'm also only going in with the light tones at the minute till I find out where all this greenery is. I've probably already gone and covered some on it because I can't really tell what's what at the minute. Rub it in a bit more now. Now, start and bring some grey in because they have quite a bit of grey in the tails. So we want some grey tones in it. I've started off with the light grey. I can build up to dark grey after. I want to red. Again. Try not to get that leaf. The beauty of pastels is if you've gone a colour that you're not happy with, you can go over it with a different colour and it'll blend in and change the look altogether. Bring that red up there now. Now we want a shadowing, so I'm going to go dark, which I've got it here, and it's just at the base. go. Right, now I'm going to have a look at the overall picture now and see what needs changing. Thank you, Tracy. Right. We've got an harsh line between the shadow at the base and the light at the top. So we want something mid-colour in between. So I'm going to come in with a ready orange and just take it off where the dark is. We don't need much of it. I'm bringing it up to just below the midpoint. I'm not going any higher. I've covered some of that leaf. I'll have to rub it out. Hi Joey, welcome. That's that for that. And that same orange, I'm going to take on the back end of this leg just as it's coming down here. It in again. Look at the screen, make sure I've got the tone right when my hand catches up. And then if I'm happy, which I am, then I go and rub it in. And that's got that tone right now. And same at the back here, we want some more in there. Pat it in again. To catch up. Yep, right, can rub that in then. Thank you, Joey. Right, it needs some dark in there, it's not showing back or his back up very well, so I'm going to come just on the edge and blend it in. That's better. Take some red off it. little bit. Now I want the light again and bring it off that. That way it blends into both colours. Random spots. Not going for red in it yet. It's looking too yellow at my end. I don't know what it's looking like at your end. Thank you. It is looking nice and soft, isn't it? Right. Now I could do with some grey tones in it. Take away from the orange effect of the fur, which grey doesn't. That one. That's just odd sections, I'm not doing it everywhere. Better. Right, I want some more shading just on his front from where it's coming off his leg. Just on these bits here. No, I don't, because that's not part of him. Look, see, even I make mistakes. Where's my rubber? Bear with me a sec, guys. I've left my rubber on the other side. Yeah. See, I'm not a robot after all. I'm just human. Right, here's where I wanted to go. I want some more shading in Baseries White. And just off the edge of the red. Take some colour direct and just deepen this edge. There we go, and I think it needs a bit more just under this chin. Make sure you're still on screen. Just that. That's okay, Kimmy. Enjoy your rest. Have a good day. There we go. Just a light touch on that bit. That's it for that. And I'm bringing the picture down a bit, see if I need any grey up here. And it catches up. Shade behind his ear a bit more. In the centre. Right, I've got one that's fairly clean. How about a nanas? Just about used them all. I have to buy some more. Right, I want a greeny blue touch just in his eye. Same one as the other one. That's that. Some dark round his nose. That. Right, I think I can start on the greenery now. Can highlight more of the fox with pencils after. So, I'm going to have to quickly go and rub some of this out here and see if I've got some with no colour on. No, they're not brilliant, these ones, because they tend to drop to bits on me, but if I can get one or two leaves at a time out on them, then it don't matter. Right, I want some of that green. Just at the base of these leaves. Have to keep looking up at the screen to see if I'm looking at the right place for leaves, because when you look at the paper, they're just all black lines, you can't tell shape. So I have to keep looking up and see if I've got it right. I suppose I can make my own leaves. Could just not look right. I'm just gently blend that in. Again, I'm only using pastels as a base colour on these leaves. Could go in with pencil after. I think that's leaf. That's definitely leaf, isn't it? Bye, Tracy. Have a good day. A lighter touch at the top of these. There. Got to turn paper a bit, guys, else I can't twist my arm enough. A bit of colour in it, it's looking too light. Try that. That's better. Let's carry on with that green down here then. It's raining fast again. Canary, it's in front of the bungalow. It's not stopped for 3 days, Jodie. We're getting a bit fed up on it. We want some sunshine. It's been non-stop. Light rain, then it goes heavy, then it goes light again. It just doesn't stop. I don't know about Africa having monsoon season, I think UK's getting it. Yeah. I think the whole of UK's been having it this week. Since Friday, I think it started. Bring a second tone in these leaves so they don't look so flat. No, this one. that bit of colouring there.
Oh, that's it.
Right, now what to do on this base? I think a grey, like pebbles, would be nice down on this bit. Wait for my picture to catch up so I can see if I'm on screen. There we go. Right. Brown in it. Do you want him fussing again?
I think he's wanting me to go through to the bedroom.
Yeah? Mm, probably does.
He's been through twice and then gone back again. It's a bit early yet though, Ted. I know I go to bed early, but...
Not this early.
12:10 is a bit early. Oh, his bloody ankle then. Bloody hell, Ted.
Thought that were your knee. I don't think it were him.
It was his ankle.
You might need some more painkiller in a bit then.
Fine. Let's put a hand over it, Ted, see if it's warm.
Damp's not doing him any good.
No. Yeah, it stopped hurting bloody shit.
Of course he wants to do what other cats are doing.
Well, yeah,
they go out, he wants to go out. Oh, thank you, Pickle. I do try my best. Putting a bit of moss in, just in areas. It would look like a couple of weeds coming up through ground. Just pat it in again. soft brush. Not that one. That one. I'm just going to blend it into the paper a bit more. I've got right. Now I want some that's showing behind it, the leaves as well, because otherwise it's going to look odd. So I'm going to take some in between the leaves. Just to that, some brown mixed with it. Try not to catch his white fur. Oliver's not been in all morning. I think he's in studio.
I thought you expected him being in this nurse.
Mm-hmm. No, I think he's in studio.
Right.
Is his belly still on?
What's up, mister? You're not comfortable, are you? Me?
No, I think that's why he's waiting for you to go through.
I do, because he's fidgeting.
As soon as the stream's finished, I'll give him some painkiller. Alright, some moss again. He's a bit close to his fur.
Well,
got back up. Bye, Connie. Have a good day. Good day. Can't get my words out. Right. Now for a bit of blue for the sky. Clean my hands first so I don't go and transfer all this dark colouring. My belly's rumbling now.
Is it?
A bit too hard with that, so try and blend it out a bit.
Okay.
one of Daft Cats has come in, did you say?
Damp.
Oh, damp.
Mates is wet through.
Alright.
Somebody come through just before. And he's laying down underneath this quilt.
Yeah.
All snuggled. Little eyes keep going.
Try and lift some of this.
Don't you dare touch him, missus. No. Oh!
What are you doing?
It's alright, Ted. She's come through and seen him comfortable on here.
Yeah.
And she's jumped up and swiped him with paw.
Mm.
So he's his doctor. Okay, Ted. She's a bugger, isn't she? Hmm? Of course, she's not seen you for a minute. It's okay, Ted. Good boy. I'll get her for you, Ted. Can't you come fast? Throw me a cup at her. To be like bike sheds at 4 to 4. Eh? Beat her up. Beat her.
That patch is still showing up, so I'm going to try and rub some of this out. Where's my cloth pump? Try and get that lifted up and then try again. More heavy-handed than I thought. Let's try that. Have a new piece. my stomach. Anybody think I'd not had no tea yet? Right. Well, that's all base done. Just need to come in with some highlight pencil now. Try that one. And tone this red down a bit. It's a bit under this eye still. Make sure I've not got off screen. Sorry if you can hear my stomach, guys. That's enough there. Just under this nose here. Some of my grey in. Just want to deepen this shadow other side of this ear and down back at ear. Base of this ear. Blue off that's printed out. I think it's because I've got low on my black, so it's done it blue. Right, anywhere else? Yeah, the Derwent pastel pencils, these ones. Let's see if I can get the tin. The ones. Come on screen so I can see if I'm in the right place. My phone's got a very big lag. There we go. Yeah, them ones. Really good. And they're not high priced either. I get quite a bit of pigment out of them. So, right, where do I need a bit more? Still some more down here. Following the lines that were printed in, adding shadow to it. This is pretty cream undertone in with the white, just so it don't look so flat. And that's it. I'll call him finished. I'll zoom out again, guys, so you can see him. Come on, zoom out. There we go. And that's my little fox. Thank you, Joey. So what do you think, guys? Are you a pastel convert? Are you going to give it a try? I think everybody's gone off to have the dinner. So that's it for me today. Thank you all for coming. Yeah, I'm gonna ask Ian to seal it with some pastel sealant, just a light spray of that and it'll be done. So enjoy your dinner, everybody, and enjoy the rest of your day, and I hope to see you again soon. Thank you for coming. Bye. Where's stop gone?